was supposed to be starting back today.
He is. He's probably running late.
Well, maybe it's too soon.
No, I saw him yesterday. He looks a whole lot better.
Well, when I see him, he looked like death warmed up.
He'd be here.
Because you say so.
No, because it's about time he got back into the real world.
So there you are, young lady. What time did you get up this morning?
Didn't look at the clock.
Well, I did. And it was just gone six. Now look, Peggy.
Have you seen the state of these covers, Frank? You know, I can't believe we've let them get like this.
Hey, I got a message last night about little Liam's christening. Ricky and Bianca want the Victor saw out the catering.
They want over here?
Well, what's wrong with that?
Nothing. I'm just a bit surprised, that's all. After everything that's happened. I'm delighted. It'll be good to have something nice to look forward to. As long as I'm actually still here for it.
Now, come on, Peggy.
I'm so scared.
Well, of course you are, darling. That's only natural.
Huh. Does that make any difference?
Well, no.
Then why say it, then?
Well, to be quite honest, Peggy, I don't know. And I really don't know what to say at the moment. Hey, this is nice.
I found her when I was clearing out.
Always a looker, eh? Peggy, look. Everything is going to be fine. I promise you.
I'm going to go for a walk, Frank.
Yeah.
I'm going, and so's Dot.
Yes, well, I mean, I might look in.
Yes, I'm going to go along and all.
Are you?
We both are.
What?
Well, it's a dance class. I've got to have a dance partner.
I don't even know what salsa is.
Yes, but you'll find out tonight, won't you?
What is this, Pat?
It'll be good for you.
What, charging around some golly club doing a dance I've never heard of?
No, relaxing, doing something different from work.
Well, don't I have any say in this?
No.
I was just passing, thought to see how you are. About to feel a bit weird first day back.
Yeah, well, to tell the truth, it does. Hardly slips again.
Well, maybe the sooner you start seeing this counsellor, the better.
I told you I don't want to see a counsellor. It's bad enough.
What?
Letting myself down in front of people that I know.
You haven't let yourself down? It's no wonder things got on top of you. We've had thrown at you lately. But you'll get through this. Today's the first step.
And you're here to make sure that I take it, right?
I'm not trying to poke my nose in.
I know you do. And that is the difference between you and someone who's just being paid to listen. Do you want a cup of tea?
No, thanks. I've got to be off.
Oh, if you see Bianca, can you tell her that I'll be out in a bit?
Yeah, sure.
See ya. Hello?
Fernando, I'm sorting it out as we speak, yeah. Of course there's going to be enough space. There's a dance floor, isn't it? All right. I should have stuck to Matthew and his disco.
Hello there.
Sorry, mate, we haven't opened yet.
I know, DCI Mason. I want to speak to you, Mr. Steve Owen.
You're speaking to him. What can I do for you?
It's about Saskia Duncan.
Oh, yeah?
So how was he?
He was up and dressed.
He still ain't here, though.
He will be. Grant, Simon's starting back on the stool today, so if you see him, tread carefully. He's still pretty fragile, yeah?
Yeah, we won't be seeing him because me and Courtney are going away.
When?
Later on today.
You said Simon could see Courtney.
He can, when we get back.
Oh, so much for peace, eh?
Look, he can see Courtney when it suits me, not when it suits him. We'll be back in a week or so.
It's just what he needs right now, Grant.
I meant what I said at pre-sale.
So when you come back,
you can see Courtney.
You mean you've actually heard of it?
No. It wasn't called salsa in my day. It was the tango, the mambo, and the cha-cha-cha.
The what?
Yeah, mock-knock, young lady. I was a fair old mover in my youth.
Mine was too. I'd never see you on the dance floor today, though. You! Are you going to the club tonight?
Three tequila slammers, I'll be first through that door.
Grant?
Mum?
Yes.
How's the little darling then?
She's fine. What was this? Something only, me and Courtney got some packing to do. We're going to see Nigel for a little holiday.
Oh, nice. So, how long will you be away for?
Why, are you worried we're going to miss the wedding?
Actually, Grant, no. I wasn't even thinking about the wedding. It's this next week or so. Things could be getting a little bit tricky.
Well, if it's covering the vicar after, you'll have to forget it. That job offer of Annie's, well, I'm probably going to accept it.
Oh, well, good luck then.
I'm not actually a close-knit family, as the sister Claudia was the first one to admit.
Saskia never gave me the impression she was a doting daughter.
Ah, but the father's birthday bash, I mean, it was tradition.
What, and there's been no contact since?
Nope, no calls, no letters, nothing. And yet it seems she had a very strong reason to stay put.
Oh, yeah?
That reason being you, Mr. Owen.
I don't understand.
Well, her sister showed us some emails she received from Miss Duncan a couple of weeks ago. It seems that she thinks you and her were getting it back together again. Oh, she was in cloud nine about it.
We've met up again, yeah. You know, had a few drinks, been out once or twice.
Well, and that was it?
Look, you have to understand something about Saskia and Mr.
DCI Mason.
DCI Mason. Saskia's a fantasy merchant.
So what you're saying is there was, nothing in this relationship?
Nothing.
Health inspectors in the area, word's going round.
So
I just thought I'd tell you, that's all.
I do a good job, don't I? Inspector or no inspector?
What are you so touchy about? I never said you didn't.
Look, Rosa, can we just clear the air a little bit here?
How do you mean?
Well, for a start, can we get the stupid mix-up over the Valentine's card out of the way?
There's nothing to say. That was just a simple misunderstanding.
Oh, well. In that case, why don't we go to the salsa class tonight,
then? Jeff, I've got a restaurant to run.
Oh, we can manage without you for one night. Come on, it could be good fun.
Are you asking me out?
Not exactly asking you out. Exactly.
Jeff, we've got a great working relationship. I don't want to ruin it.
Yeah, okay.
Right.
Stop telling lies about me. Leave my friends alone and get out of my life.
That was a copy of a message we retrieved from Miss Duncan's answer phone machine when we looked round her flat. It seems to have ended very badly between you two, Mr. Owen.
Yeah. Yeah, it did.
So, have you seen Miss Duncan since you left this message?
She came to the club one night.
And did you part on better terms?
No. I was seeing someone else at the time, and she was interfering. So I laid it on the line. I wanted her out of my life for good.
Well, she should have got the message.
Yeah. Yeah, but I'm not exactly proud of how I handled it. In fact,
What?
Ever since Claudia came to see me, I've been going back over what I said to Saskia. She was very upset.
So what are you saying? Do you think she was so upset that she might have done something to herself?
Saskia's never been the most well-balanced of girls.
Well, did she give you any indication that she might harm herself?
No.
Why did you not mention all this before?
Because I really don't want to think about it. I mean, don't you see? If Saskia has done something stupid, then it'd be down to me, wouldn't it?
Go on. I hear it's going to be quite lively, if you get my drift.
All those Latin American rhythms.
Pulsating stuff, eh?
Yeah,
just like their football.
You mean you haven't noticed anything?
Not really, no.
I always thought you and your mum were close.
We are.
But you haven't clocked how weird she's been acting lately. It's like she's on another planet some days. I just thought she might have said something to you.
Well, how do you mean weird?
Well, we may not be love's young dream, but you can still expect a bit of romance, can't you?
All right, so what do you think it is? I mean, is she depressed about something?
Been like going to bed with an iceberg.
Terry, this is my mother we're talking
about.
Yeah,
well, all I'm saying is that for a newly married couple, we're not exactly breaking any records, that's all.
I'll see you later.
Well, what have I said? Women.
Got it.
Well... thanks very much, Mr. Owen.
I'll be in touch.
Yeah.
hospitals. Why does everyone watch their medical programs, you think?
It's like those disaster shows. Everyone loves them too, don't they?
People are mad.
No, no. I don't understand it.
Hey?
Well, you know, if it's happening to someone else, it's not happening to you, is it?
Mrs. Mitchell?
So, when's Grant going?
As soon as he can, from what he told me.
Yeah, well, they'll be back, I suppose.
Yeah.
Simon? It's okay.
Well, you're taking this better than I thought.
Yeah, well, actually, I've just had some good news.
Oh, makes a change for around here.
I had a phone call from my mum. She's coming back to the square.
What do you think? Well, it's a store. No, it's space, and space in a shop means money. So what are you going to do? Not through, yeah?
There's no need, really.
I mean, just open it up, give it a lick of paint, put some shelves up, and there it will be.
There what will be?
Out here, for all the current up-to-date stuff. Through there, the Bill's second-hand market for things that are too good to throw away. Not quite like that, you know, too good to throw away.
So that's what I'm going to be doing for the next few days, painting and decorating.
Well, the hand wouldn't go, miss.
That's terrific.
Besides, I thought you might like a say in how the business you're going to be managing looks. But you're always going on about how you want to be someone by the time you're 30. Well, turn that into something.
Now, we've completed all the tests that we set out to do today.
And?
As your GP should have explained to you, there'll be a small delay now while we wait for the results.
But how much of a wait would that be?
Well, we'll call you on Monday morning and set up an appointment.
Well, why can't you do that now?
I'm sorry, we would normally, but we've got a few problems.
If it's cancer, what are my chances?
It depends on so many factors, I can't answer that.
Is there a possibility I might die?
Mrs. Mitchell, each case is different. There's no point in our discussing this any further until I get the test results.
Even if you're not 100% sure, I'd still rather know.
Peggy, the doctor's right, darling. I mean, what's the point?
The point is, I have a right to know.
Mrs. Mitchell, you seem determined to press me for answers, which I can't give you at this moment.
I just want to know, could this kill me? Thank you, Doctor.
Excuse me. You haven't seen Ricky, have you? He's meant to be meeting me in his lunch.
No, but Peggy was looking for you earlier on.
Oh.
She told me to say yes if I saw you. She'd be delighted.
What?
Just give her an idea of the numbers you're expecting as soon as you can and she'll get cracking.
Numbers for what?
For on Wednesday. Liam's christening party.
Thanks for telling me.
What, you mean you didn't know?
I didn't have a clue. Who told Peggy?
I think Frank mentioned it.
Who told Frank?
I don't know.
Ricky.
Excuse me.
I reckon it must be him.
But he's drinking bitter.
So?
Well, it's not very Latin, is it? Swigging a pint of heavy.
Well, that's fine.
Another half a minute, please, love.
Coming right up. Excuse me. Can you settle a bet for us?
Yeah, sure.
And we were wondering if you were the salsa teacher for the E20 tonight.
Don't tell me it's these snake hips of mine.
No, it's the dance club badges on your bag.
Fernando Rodriguez Lopez.
Is that your real name?
What? Do you think I'd make that up? Can I get you a drink?
Yeah, I'll have a vodka and coke, please.
Vodka and coke as well, please, love.
No.
It's probably these last few months, everything that's been happening.
Left you feeling pretty low, hasn't it?
Oh, my God.
Well, Terry seems really worried about you.
What does he know?
Well, look, I should have noticed something.
Maybe it's just that. But they call it that seasonal thing them Scandinavians get.
Maybe you need some sort of a tonic, you know? Pick me up.
I'm not about to put my head in the oven, you know.
Why didn't you go see the doctor?
Oh, what for?
For some advice. And he was really helpful when you went to see him about your back, wasn't he?
Oh, just to shut you up, I'll go, OK? Ask him to give me a happy pill. Get him to give you one while I'm at it. Stop you moping about the place.
Yeah, well, actually, I've decided to go to that salsa class tonight.
What, this one?
Well, I just feel like doing something different, that's all.
Oh, that's great. What are you going to wear?
This.
Come on. Let's go home. Let's see if we can't find something even better.
Yeah, Mum.
Oh.
Well, I don't know anything about it.
Well, who told Peggy then?
Well, we're not doing anything on Wednesday, are we?
It's not the point, Ricky.
Who's coming? Did she say?
It's not the point. It's our christening.
He did what?
He asked me to go along with him.
You're not actually going, though.
What if I was?
I'm not going to a nightclub with my mum.
As it happens, I said no, but it wasn't to spare your feelings. It's because I didn't want him to get the wrong idea.
By going to a dance together?
Well, after that business with the Valentines, I thought it was for the best.
I thought that was all misunderstanding.
It shows the way his mind's working.
So what if he was interested in you?
Well, I don't want him to be.
Well, why not? You like him, don't you?
Yeah.
He's a nice fella.
Yeah.
Good company.
Teresa.
Bit of a laugh.
Will you stop it now?
Calm down.
I am perfectly calm.
Now what's wrong?
I can't stop thinking about Louise coming back.
You're not going to tell Simon, are you? Because I don't think it's exactly going to do him a whole lot of good right now, is it?
Well, what am I supposed to do?
Well, all I'm saying is you've got to think about Simon.
Hey, Steve. We got the wrong night, or what?
You here for the salsa class?
Oh.
Yeah? Then you're in the right place.
So, where's all the women?
Come on, girls. Come through. Fun's just about to start. Go on to the dance floor.
This has got
to
be a wind-up.
Dad?
You're here through choice.
You're enjoying it.
Hokey-dokey, everybody, let's make a start. Please, line up. Boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl. Let's get ready for the warm-up. This way. Come along now, don't be shy, I won't bite you. Find your positions quickly. Very good indeed. Now, choose carefully. The person next to you will be your partner when we move on to stage two.
Just when you thought things couldn't get any worse, eh?
My name is Fernando. Hola!
Hola!
Hola! That is good. Now, can anybody tell me where the salsa music comes from? Yes?
Cuba?
Superb, senorita. Come, shadow me. Do everything I do. Now, all you have to remember with the salsa is that there are four counts. That's uno, dos, tres steps, and one pause.
We're dancing, not rhythmic.
Now, we'll begin by doing the basic steps. So everybody step back on the right foot. As you're stepping back on the right foot, pick up the left foot. Now put the left foot down on the ground and bring the right to join the left. And Bob's your father's brother. That's the basic steps all sorted. So let's go for it, shall we?
I'm not sure.
Hey, whoa, 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 I don't know what the heck I'm doing.
It's just a warm-up.
Watch me, Daddy.
Just relax, have fun. And let's go, go, go! Come on, let yourself go. Roll the hips. Enjoy. Let it flow.
I'll join in when they know what they're doing. Can I have a tequila, please?
Of course.
Look, darling, why don't you go and have a lay down?
Yeah, in a minute. Doctor, are you in a hurry?
Just going to check out that salsa night.
I've been down the hospital.
And?
They did a load of tests, but they wouldn't tell me anything.
You know you have to wait for the results. That's routine.
And this pain in my stomach. Is that routine?
Did you tell the consultant about this?
Well, it's actually more like a churning than a pain.
And how long have you had it?
It came on this morning. And my chest, that feels tight as well.
It sounds like an anxiety attack, but you better get it checked out anyway.
Oh, I'm sorry, Doctor. I shouldn't go on at you like this.
Did Frank go with you today?
Try stopping him.
Well, these sort of things are often easier when there's someone around.
Are they, though? Oh, I hear what you're saying. But isn't it just someone else to consider? Well, maybe all you should be thinking about is yourself.
It's someone to worry about you when you need it most.
And back. And forward. Strong man, strong.
I've noticed you around.
Now with the
one,
two, and three. Come along, gents. The ladies are putting you to shame. Senorita, you are a natural. I can't believe you've not done this before.
Okay.
You think this is fun? Wait till stage two. Look at your partners while you're dancing.
Will you stop coming?
stepping into me. Talk about two left feet.
He's a wild stallion. Tame him.
My friend, just take small steps.
I'm doing my best, don't I?
I'll dance him in the dark.
My darling, don't force the hips like that. This is salsa, not belly dance.
Just pay £1.50 for this.
All on your own, then? Well, you should have asked someone to partner you.
I did, Rosa didn't fancy it.
Well, I don't understand her. If you'd asked me, I would have said yes like a shot.
I think I'll just go and fill this from the tap.
Work up that thirst. Tequila!
Have you got a bed that this never sees?
Leave it to Rosa.
You look nice. No, really. Shouldn't have bothered though, it's not much on offer.
What about the teacher?
Well, snake pants, don't think so. Oh, fancy him, do you? Why, don't you? Maybe. Reckon you're boxing out your weight there.
Well, I reckon I could get him to buy me a drink.
Five because you can't.
You're on. He's coming over. Here's Steve.
Give me a minute.
Better luck next time. Fancy tequila?
Yeah, why not?
Back to the backwards and forwards then. Here we go.
Can't wait to see you. Yeah, I love you too. Till I die. Bye. And that was Diane. She just got me a letter about the wedding. I can't wait for the end night.
Nice.
Peggy. Peggy, please. What's happening? Ever since we got back from the hospital, it's like someone's thrown a switch.
I don't want to talk about the wedding.
But why not? You said yourself it's nice to have things to look forward to.
Because I keep thinking, will I be here or at the hospital or maybe...
What? What?
You know what I'm thinking.
Listen, it's no good thinking ifs and maybes all the time, sweetheart. All that matters is today, here and now. We've got our wedding plans to sort out.
There's no point in trying to pretend that there's nothing wrong.
Or
sticking your head in
all
the
right,
sand.
Fine. Okay, fine. Now, listen, we won't talk about weddings anymore, all right? As long as we keep on talking, please. Listen, whatever happens... good or bad, we're gonna get through this together, as long as you don't shut me out.
It's just every time I look forward, I get this, I don't know, this really chilly feeling, like I'm seeing all these lives, yours, Grant's, Phil's, and I don't know if I'm gonna be a part of them anymore.
Hey, you're gonna be a part of our lives for a very long time to come. Now listen to me. Nobody is going to split us up. And nothing, nothing is going to keep you away from me.
Is that a threat or a promise?
Hey, that's my girl. That's my girl.
So we were talking to the police. What did they want?
Outside. It's good. Very, very good. Senorita, so graceful, like a gazelle.
I think I'll take a breather if I may, Fernando.
My heart will stop beating till you return.
You stay there, Lionel. You're good.
To your left.
He said left.
Look, I've just got a bit of a problem with left and right. That's all.
That boy. Oh,
no way.
Don't be such a baby. It's fun.
Oh, it's torture.
It's good for you. Come on.
Okay.
It's the ankle.
And it's so good for you, isn't it?
I'm serious.
Oh, come on, come and sit down.
Oh.
Left, 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 left.
You're not stopping?
Might be safer. I've had nothing but a come on all night.
Lucky old Jeff.
Yeah, wait till I tell you from. It's obvious Lily sent me that Valentine's card and then gave me the impression it'd come from your mum.
Maybe that's what you wanted to believe.
All I want to raise is a good working atmosphere, no complications.
So you don't fancy mum, then?
No!
Pity.
Why?
It's just these vibes I've been picking up.
What? From Rosa? About me?
Still. You said you didn't care.
Oh, I'm too old for this.
No one's too old for it, Jeff.
Got a minute?
You look as though you're enjoying yourself. Oh, just entering into the spirit of the evening.
I think I need a tomato juice.
It looks like you sprained it to me. I'm going to need to get some ice over here.
Great.
Well, I think it's sweet. It's embarrassing, sending Valentine's cards at her age. I mean, you'd think she would have grown out of crushes by now.
Everything's fine.
How can it be fine? The police are onto you.
They're not onto anyone. They're just asking a few questions.
What about Saskia?
There's nothing to worry about, Matt.
Have they found her?
My sister's reported her missing. I told them she was depressed, but we'd had her out.
Well, that was pretty stupid, wasn't it?
No, I told them she'd left the inn in right old state. Then I let them draw their own conclusions.
And you expect the police to go with that? That she was so upset she's topped herself?
When no other explanation turns up, why not? And there will be no other explanation. So as long as we both keep quiet.
We?
Yeah, the police want to talk to everyone who was in the club the last time I saw her.
Including me?
Yeah. I mean, I had to give them your name, didn't I? It would look silly if I didn't.
Right, OK. What do I say when they ask me the last time I actually saw her?
You tell them what we agreed.
I've never been a good liar, Steve.
Well, then you better start practising. Because you've bottled out on this one, Matt. You're next on the block too.
No.
Right.
Next on Drama, we're back in Albert Square with more classic EastEnders.